You may have seen code which chains a bunch of methods like this. This is an example of the builder pattern from the Zero Log library. Hi, my name's Wani Bryson. The builder pattern is a great way to expressively configure structures and simplify maintenance by keeping the configuration logic in one place. It's worth mentioning that traditionally, the builder pattern includes a director, but today we're just going to focus on the builder itself. We'll start by creating a client, which will communicate with a server. Then we'll use a builder to create that client for us. And finally, we'll show how we can configure our client using builder methods. So we're going to start with a client which connects with a server. So I'm going to create a package called tutorial/builder. And then we're going to create a main.go file, give it the package name main, and then create ourselves a main function. Inside here, I'm going to create an HTTP client, and I'm going to give it a timeout of 5 seconds. I'll save that to import our external packages, and next I'm going to get the response and the error from a call to c.head, which will get the headers from this wani.net server. Next, I want to print out the results, so I'm going to say if error does not equal nil, then we should be printing the error with format printf, and we'll say error value new line, and then pass the error in there. And next, we're going to say else, if the error is nil, then we have a valid response, so we can use format printf, and we'll say the status of our response is a value, and the value that we'll pass in will be the response.status. If we save this, jump back into the terminal, and call go run, then it connects to the server and gets the headers back, and we get a status OK. Now we're going to write our client builder. So we'll start by defining a type, HTTP client builder, which will start as an empty struct. Next, we want to create a new builder function, and this is going to return the address of an HTTP client builder. Inside here, we're just going to return that address and keep it empty for now. And next, we want to create our build method. So we'll use our builder as the receiver and call this build, and then return the pointer to an HTTP client. Inside, we're just going to say return the address of an HTTP client and set the timeout to 5 times time.second. So now that we have our builder, we can jump into main and replace this with new builder dot build. And if we save this and jump into the terminal and call go run again, then we get status OK. As it currently is, our builder isn't really any better than a typical constructor, but what we're going to do now is add a configuration method. So the configuration that I want to add is basically being able to jump in here and say timeout, and then add our own timeout here. Say we want to do something like time.millisecond. So how are we going to go about that? Well, the first thing we're going to need to do is add a field to this struct, and I'm going to just call this timeout and make it a type of time.duration. The next thing we want to do is add our default up in the new builder rather than in the build method. So we'll just set our builder timeout to 5 times time.second. And down here in the build method, we're now going to use our builder.timeout instead. The next thing we'll want to do is add our timeout method for configuring the timeout. So we'll create a function where our builder is the receiver, and we'll call this timeout, and it takes a single argument of type time.duration, and it needs to return the builder as well. And inside here, we're going to say b.timeout is equal to timeout, and then return b. Now, if we save this and run it in the terminal, because we set a timeout of only 1 millisecond here, my expectation is that we're actually going to get a timeout error. And we do get a timeout error, which shows that the builder configured the timeout as we expected. While the example in this tutorial is relatively trivial, builders are a great technique for keeping the creation of structs in Go clean and maintainable. I've been Wani Bryson, happy building, and I'll see you later.